Thank you for loving us. If when you are yet sinners, the Bible says you die for us. You keep loving us regardless of what we are. Though you don't like us doing the wrong thing.
CDC is trying. Nobody really know what is going on except God. And nobody really have the answer except God. Thank God for the doctors. Medical personnel, they are running away from work because they are overwhelmed. They are overloaded. Many of them have lost their life in the course of saving the life of those who are affected. Right here in our very eyes, we see Bible coming to pass. In a time like this, what is the answer? The answer is what the three young Hebrew men said, their confession. That's the answer. Said, our God that we serve will deliver us.
Redeemed Christian Church of God, Chapel of Restoration, located at 1001-1005 Morris Avenue, Bronx, New York, where we prepare a whole people in an unholy world. Welcome back to church. We have measures in place in line with the CDC guidelines for your safety. The sanctuary has been thoroughly sanitized and disinfected, so be rest assured that you'll be worshiping the Lord in a clean and healthy environment. Carefully listen to the following information for your safety and the safety of others, and please comply with them. If you drive, complimentary parking is available at 283rd East 164th Street between College and Morris Avenues. When you come into the church, remember to stay 6 feet apart from others at all times. Face masks are required before entering the church. If you do not have one, it will be provided to you free of charge at the door. Please put it on immediately. New York State requires you to wear a face mask, so do we. Your temperature will be checked before giving the all clear signal to enter the sanctuary. Hand sanitizers are also available at the door. Use it before entering the church. Our ushers will then direct you to your designated seats based on your family size. Please obey all instructions. The seats have been arranged so that members of the same family can sit together.
Hallelujah. Give praise to the name of the Most High God for this second day of our 23rd anniversary. Wherever you are, underneath the sound of my voice, please join us as we lift up our voices to the Most High God. Give Him thanks, the keeper of our lives. Give Him thanks, is our strength, is our defense. Bless the name of the Most High God who has kept us thus far. Hallelujah be unto your holy name, Ancient of Days, King of Glory. We adore your wonderful name. Be magnified forevermore in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord for his presence yesterday. Give him thanks who has given unto us the opportunity to witness the 23rd anniversary of this great commission. Magnify the name of the Lord for his mercies that endureth forevermore. Thank him, O Lord God, Makebos Keboli Kashuri Gabos Kebolia, for his grace. And the multiple of his power of mercy upon our lives and destinies. Magnify the name of the Lord, the keeper of our Israel, who has been keeping us in our going, in our coming, and who has helped us thus far. Magnify the name of the Lord, who has been our helper in the ages past. Maleke Boske Bolia Sauri Gabolia. and our help in the years to come. Glorify the name of the Lord. He is the Ancient of Days. He is the King of Glory. He is the I Am that I Am. He is the Almighty God. Bible says, if it had not been the Lord who had been on our side, if it had not been the Lord who had been on our side, what would have become of our story today? But I want to bless the name of the Lord who had been on our side. He says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. And of a truth, the mercy of the Lord has been following us. His goodness has been following us. Celebrate God's mercy. Celebrate his goodness upon our destinies. The reason why we are still on the land of the living. Hallelujah, be unto your holy name. Glory, honor, and adoration be unto your wonderful name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank him, O Lord God, for the opportunity of starting this meeting yesterday. Magnify the name of the Lord for his move. And bless the name of the Lord for his presence again in this place tonight. Give him glory, give him praise for what is yet to do again. Tonight is the youth night, and he's given unto us the strength of the youth. He's given unto us enablement to fulfill the intention of Jehovah in the midst of this meeting tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. Join me as we ask for the mercy of the Lord to move again. Let the rain of his mercy fall upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. No sin will stand, for there shall be pardon in the house, in the mighty name of Jesus. That every limitation of sin be silenced by the power of your mercy, in the mighty name of Jesus. The theme of this anniversary, Maleke Boske Bolika Sirika Boske Bolia, is limitless. In the face of limitless, there's no limitation that can stop us. We are unstoppable. We are unstoppable. No sin shall stop any man from stepping into his grace, into his glory. As for the Lord's mercy that conquered the power of sin, as for the mercy of the Lord to be at work, forgiveness of sin to be at work, even in the course of this meeting tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, to speak forth unto Jerusalem, tell our warfare is ended, and our iniquities is pardoned, in the mighty name of Jesus, that the sin of any man will not stand before him or her tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, mercy will prevail. When the Lord was to bless Israel, the sin of Ephraim was remembered. No sin will hinder the flow of your blessing tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's call upon the name of the Lord for his mercy and ask for the Spirit of the Lord to come to work. The Spirit of the Lord that can never be stopped. The Spirit that empowers, that by his Spirit, everyone ministering to them shall be empowered. That flesh will not limit any man. That flesh will not speak through any man. In the mighty name of Jesus, no limitation on the path of every minister today, from the point of this opening prayer, Maleke Boske Bolia, to the point of the benediction, no man shall be limited by the flesh or carnality, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take control in the mighty name of Jesus. Even the preeminent control of anyone that is to perform one function or the other tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. Flesh will not rule over any. Flesh will not hinder any. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, mighty God. The Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit of help. We decree help for everyone that Jehovah will be using tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus. Even for his servant, Mareke Boske Bolika Silia, that will be ministering today from United Kingdom, Maleke Bolia. Help from above by the Spirit of the Lord. Help of the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, mighty God. Glory be unto your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. And in Psalms 103 from verse 1. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Say, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Will forgiveth all thy iniquities, will healeth all thy diseases, and will redeemeth thy life from destruction, will crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies. This is the list of what God has done. And beyond this list, I want us to decree, do greater thing in this meeting. In the mighty name of Jesus, heal also in this meeting. In the mighty name of Jesus, deliver also in this meeting. in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift also in this meeting. Save also in this meeting. In the mighty name of Jesus. That one that is still hearing me on the sick bed, let there be healing in the mighty name of Jesus, even to the sick, in the mighty name of Jesus. Strength for the depressed, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be a turnaround in the course of this meeting. In Psalm 103, we have read the list of the greatness of the Lord, the doing of the Most High God, the sure mercies of the Lord, the works of the Lord, the mighty act of the Lord. Let your mighty act also be repeated in this meeting tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, that somebody will remember this meeting as the day that as Samuel was delivered, as the day that the miracle was delivered, as the day that Isaac, the laughter, is delivered, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be tangible evidence of God's presence in this meeting tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every king that stands against the move of the Lord, every Sennacherib that is standing to take the belonging of the children of God, we stop such tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power that hijack the blessings of men from the midst of the meeting, we stop such in the mighty name of Jesus. Make a decree that this meeting we answer by his name. There shall be no limit for anyone, none shall be limited, no limitation in the mighty name of Jesus. Every wall standing for limitation is broken tonight in the name of Jesus. Every hindrance is destroyed tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. Every Red Sea is parted tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. No hindrance, no demonic interruption in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power in the Maleke Boskebulia, walking against the flow, Mayika Sauriga Boskebulia, of the work of the Lord, we silence them in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare the devices of the evil ones frustrated over every soul number among us in the mighty name of Jesus. And we decree that they will not be able to perform their enterprise in the mighty name of Jesus. The name of the Lord alone be glorified in this meeting. Release the soul that Jehovah is ready to set free in the course of this meeting, as men that the package of salvation have been prepared for, that no man will miss out in the account and the preparation of Jehovah via this meeting in the mighty name of Jesus. The blessing that have been prepared for everyone shall be delivered in the mighty name of Jesus. And no prince of Persia, no prince of this land will hinder any from partaking of that blessing. Thank you for hearing us, Lord. On this note of the doing of the Lord, we declare this meeting hoping in the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we prayed. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Brethren, you're welcome to our 23rd anniversary as we bless the name of the Lord for his mercies, for keeping us to this very moment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Father, we thank you, Lord. We appreciate you, Lord. And so we sing unto you. From the bottom of our heart, we say, Lord, bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul.
ready to dance and trade our sorrow? Yes. Even tonight as we worship our King. Hallelujah. Your hands.
Arise, 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 take your place. We lift you up on our praises.
We lift you up.
We lift you up. We lift you up. We lift you up on our praises.
To us. The Lord has been good unto us. The Lord has indeed been good unto us. The Lord has been good to Chapel of Restoration. Yes. The choir are presenting a song. It says, "You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. Who has rescued us? Our God and King and Savior." Yes, Lord, we worship you. Yes, Lord. Hey, worship him with me. You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. And I'm never going back. Hey. You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. And I'm never going back. Listen to my response. My response is Hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah. Hear it again. My response is hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah. Choir, join me. Say,
you have rescued my life.
Hallelujah.
You have rescued my life.
Hey.
And I'm never going back.
Say it again, say it again.
You have rescued my life.
Say you have rescued
my life. And I'm never going back.
What's your response? Hey.
My response is,
say
hallelujah.
Oh, you're my
redeemer.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Say
my response. Is,
thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You're my redeemer.
Hallelujah.
Say it, you have rescued my life.
You have rescued my life.
Thank you, Jesus.
You have rescued my life.
Hey,
and I'm never going back.
Chapel of Restoration, what's your response?
My response is
hallelujah,
hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah.
Say, oh. Praise, sing with me.
I'll sing your praise.
Say your oh. Praise, sing with me.
I'll sing your praise.
One more time.
I'll sing your praise. I'll sing your praise.
You have rescued our lives. You have rescued our lives. And we're never going back. Say it with me.
You have rescued our lives.
Yes, Jesus, we thank you.
You have rescued our lives. And I'm never going back.
Chapel of Restoration, say it again.
You have rescued our lives.
Yes, we thank you, Jesus.
You have rescued my life.
Say,
and we're never going back.
Our response.
Our response. Hallelujah. You're my Redeemer. Hallelujah.
Our response.
My response is Hallelujah.
You're my Redeemer.
You're my Redeemer. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You're my Redeemer. Hallelujah. Our response.
Let's go ahead one more time tonight and appreciate him. Let's celebrate him. Let's celebrate him. This is supposed to be a very powerful night because we are addressing issues that has to do with the youth. It's supposed to be a night that is full of excitement, full of vigor, full of power, that is full of fire. It's supposed to be a night that we are ready for the real thing. And as we continue tonight, I want us to still pray from the book of Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah 40, I read from verse number 29. To 31. Isaiah 40 from 29 to 31. The Bible says, "He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint." There's no doubt about it. One of the ways that the enemy always plan to limit the young people is to weary their strength, is to deflate the balloon of their strength, because he knows that that is the age when they want to get things done and get things done quick. They need all the strength, and when the strength is not there, they are limited. Even though tonight we have targeted the night of the youth, but every one of us is a youth in the hand of God, because he is the one that never gets old. And if our God never gets old, we cannot get old in the spirit realm. So tonight we are going to lift up our voice unto God. We are going to talk to God that, Father, in the name of Jesus, in any area that the balloon of the strength of our youth have been deflated, Lord, tonight fix it in the name of Jesus. As your word will be coming directly from the throne of grace, let every youth receive a touch. Can you pray for the youth? Can you pray for the youth, the young adults, all our single sisters and single brothers across the globe? Let's pray, because these are the tomorrow. These are the tomorrow of our families, the tomorrow of our community, the tomorrow of our nation. Let's pray for strength for the youth. Let's pray for strength for the youth. Spiritual strength, spiritual strength. The Bible says, even the youth shall faint and be weary. They are facing a lot of challenges, a lot of situations. They are facing a lot of difficulties. They are facing a lot of problems that is causing many of them to faint and be weary. We want to pray and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we present all the challenges, all the difficulties, all the problems that are peculiar to the youths in our community, in our nation, and in our individual family. We present them to you tonight. Jehovah God, visit them and help them in the name of Jesus. Wherever they are fainting, let strength come back. Wherever they are falling, please lift them up in the name of Jesus. There are challenges of peer pressure. There are challenges of I want to belong. I want to be part of it. I want to explore. I want to see how it looks. I want to see how it feels. They want to explore life. They want to know what is going on there. That is when they are introduced into many things that they did not even plan for. That is when they want to be rebelling against the authority above them, against the parental authority. We want to talk to God. Any attack against our youth, any attack against our young adult, any attack against our home that want to frustrate our youth, that want to cause them to be unfulfilled, that want to truncate their destiny, that want to amputate their destiny, let's pray that the help of the helpless will rise up on their behalf. If devil could not truncate the destiny of Joseph, God is still at work. He can still do it for our youth. He can still do it for our young adult. If he did not allow the enemy to destroy the destiny of Esther, God can still visit our daughters of Zion. God can still visit our sisters. God can still make our single sisters to be people that will be determined and not settle for less. In the name of Jesus, let's pray for spiritual intervention, for divine intervention, for energy from heaven, for Spirit of God to abide, to baptize our youth afresh tonight. In the name of Jesus, the man of God is going to come with seizing word. He's going to come with empowered word that God himself has empowered. He's going to come loaded, and I believe every yoke is going to be destroyed upon this mountain in the light of the youth and everyone that is watching across the globe. In the name of Jesus, tonight God will move in every home, in every community, in every corner. In the name of Jesus, every bargain, every trade by battle, every negotiation that devil is making on behalf of our young people, the Lord will terminate all his transaction, all his negotiation, all his trade by battle, all his transaction, every demonic transaction that is taking place in the spirit realm to mortgage the tomorrow of our young people. Jehovah God, we cause it to be null and void tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, our Father. We give you all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Tonight, I believe that is a night of wow, wow. I cannot wait to hear what God has prepared for us tonight. I believe strongly is a fresh bread that is baked in the oven of God in heaven and is to be delivered. You know how fresh, you know how sweet, how nourishing a fresh bread can be, especially when it's coming out fresh from the oven. Even the smell alone makes you to feel, you know, I want to eat. Your mouth begins to water, and that is exactly how I'm feeling now, because I can smell that bread that is coming from heaven. It's going to come, and it's going to be a blessed bread for the people of God tonight. But before we bring the man of God to the podium, we want to exercise our faith in blessing God with our substance tonight. We want to bless God with our substance, because I believe according to the scripture that makes us to understand that we should not even come to the presence of God empty-handed. We should not come to the presence of God where you are going to visit even the king. You go with gifts. When you are going to visit people that matter, even anyone, even cause the demand that you don't go empty-handed. Talk less our God who made the heavens and the earth. So tonight, I want you to package your offering. I want you to package your offering wherever you are, watching, you are listening. And we have all the avenue, the platform to give. We have them, I believe it's being scrolled on our screen. We have Cash App, we have Sell, we have PayPal. I believe God will use you to cause the kingdom of God to increase by ministering to people that are in need through your substance. You may not be able to go to some mission field, but your money can travel. So tonight, package your offering, and if you are paying your tithe as a member of this house, you can package your tithe. And I want you to begin to speak to your offering, speak to your tithe. Thank God for even giving you the privilege to be part of the meeting tonight and for the substance that he has given you. And begin to ask God to accept this gift you are giving, that as he receives it from you, it will multiply back into your life. Father, we give you all the glory. We thank you because we know tonight is that night we have been waiting for. That night that you are going to visit us, particularly our young people. You are going to visit our own. You are going to snatch that boy from drug addiction. You are going to snatch that girl from prostitution. You are going to cause that prodigal son that have departed from home to return. You are going to cause a transformation. You are going to cause healing in that home. Dysfunctional family is going to be healed in the name of Jesus. Every sickness and disease that have come to the bar to hinder the youths, oh God, tonight as your word comes forth, there will be healing. I receive this gift on your behalf, oh God, from your people, and I ask that the blessing that triumph over every devourer, that swallow up every devourer, will come upon this seed, and it will multiply and cause an enlargement in your kingdom to the glory of your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Choir, can we just give a danceable song for the next few minutes?
Hosanna to the Lord. Hosanna to the Lord. Hosanna to the Lord. Hosanna to the Lord.
Sing Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Sing Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Sing Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Sing Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Sing Hosanna to the Lord.
Hosanna to the Lord.
Bye.
Shout another loud hallelujah. I think I have youth in the house. Shout hallelujah. The man of God that God has prepared for us tonight to bless us on this youth night is one of our choicest pastors. Pastor and leader in the redeemed Christian Church of God. When I say choices and leader, you know what that means. God, in his infinite mercy, pick him out of many and position him where he is right now. By the special grace of God, he is a trained medical doctor who is now into full-time ministry as pastor in the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And not just a pastor of higher rank. He is a special assistant to our general overseer, and also a regional pastor in charge of all our churches, I mean FCCG, Europe, mainland, region 3. He oversees 19 nations and is the senior pastor of Royal Connections of FCCG Parish, London, United Kingdom. Is a dynamic, anointed preacher and teacher of the word. His deep passion for church growth has led him to plant over 30 churches in the United Kingdom and Europe. He has a passion for breaking new grounds, expanding frontiers, and by the grace of God, doing what others consider impossible. In fact, one of the things that believe connected me to him and him to me the first time we talk about church planting. That's how we got connected. He's my Oga. You know, when you see Oga, my boss now, by the special grace of God. So without much ado, I want us to bring Pastor Dr. Sola Oludoyi to minister the word of God to us tonight. And I want you to be ready because something great is happening in this house. Amen. Over to you, Pastor Sola.
Amen. 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 Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus. Glory, 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 glory to Jesus. We praise the name, the Yahweh of Israel, the excellency of Jacob. There is no one like him. Beautiful Savior, mighty God, Emmanuel is your name. We worship you. We praise your name. We glorify you. We lift you high tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, precious Father. We bless your holy name. You're worthy to be praised and worthy to be glorified. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
The man of God that God has prepared for us tonight, bless us on this youth night, is one of our choicest pastors, pastor and leader in the redeemed Christian Church of God. And I say choicest and leader. You know what that means. God, in his infinite mercy, pick him out of many and position him where he is right now. By the special grace of God, he's your trained medical doctor who is now into full-time ministry as pastor in the redeemed Christian Church of God. And not just a pastor of higher rank. He's a special assistant to our general overseer and also a regional pastor in charge of all our churches, I mean FCCG, Europe, mainland, region 3. He oversees 19 nations and is the senior pastor of Royal Connections of FCCG Parish, London, United Kingdom. He's a dynamic, anointed preacher and teacher of the word. His deep passion for church growth has led him to plant over 30 churches in the United Kingdom and Europe. He has a passion for breaking new grounds, expanding frontiers, and by the grace of God, doing what others consider impossible. In fact, one of the things that we believe connected me to him and him to me, the first time we talked about church planting, and that's how we got connected. He's my Oga. You know, when you see Oga, my boss now, by the special grace of God. So without much ado, I want us to bring Pastor Dr. Sola Oludoyi to minister the word of God to us tonight. And I want you to be ready because something great is happening in this house. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, glory to Jesus. Wow. Wow. That was a very powerful and extremely warm introduction. We are grateful tonight for the privilege to be here together. Thank you so much, beloved Pastor, Pastor Daniel Ajayi Adeniran, and your lovely wife, Pastor Naomi. We celebrate both of you. My wife and I are so excited that we are connected with you and connected to you and to the whole of the household of Restoration. We are thankful that it has pleased God to enable you to see the 23rd anniversary in the land of the living. Now, regardless of what may be happening around us, Jesus is Lord. He has never lost a battle. He has never abdicated his throne. He remains forever supreme on the throne. And so tonight, I'd like you to lift up your hands to heaven and just wave them to Jesus. Come on now, let's do it together. I need to be sure that you are alive. I need to be sure that after the choir has sung so powerfully, you are not yet tired. Come on now, wave those hands. Wherever you may be, wave those hands to Jesus. Come on. Just wave them, wave them, wave them, wave them, wave those hands to Jesus. Now, Psalm 47, verse 1. I always like to start this way. Why? I'm excited in God. Psalm chapter 47, verse 1 says, "Oh, clap your hands, O ye people." Come on. Clap your hands, O ye people, and shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Come on now, do it together. Put those hands together for Jesus, and then shout unto God. Shout with the voice of triumph. Shout with the voice of triumph. Shout with the voice of triumph. Jesus is alive. We honor him tonight. We appreciate him tonight. We give him the praise and the glory. Come on, Restoration House, we do put your hands together. Come on, shout, shout, shout. Clap for Jesus. He deserves all the praise and all the glory. He is good forever. He is consistently wonderful, excellently magnificent. He has never lost a battle. He reigns in the affairs of men. Come on, young folks, would you give God a shout tonight? Would you give him a praise tonight? Would you celebrate Jesus? Come on, wherever you are, wherever you're watching us from on any platform, just give him a shout. Come, give him a shout. Just give him a shout. I will rejoice and be glad in the Lord. Come on, celebrate the King of Kings. Celebrate the Lord of all. Celebrate Yahweh of Israel. Celebrate him that is able to do the impossible. We will rejoice and be glad in the name of our Lord. Father, we give you praise tonight. Thank you. Thank you for this session of teaching and praying together. Thank you. Glory to your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Now, before I start, I want to say very, very big well done. Well done, well done to the choir. That was awesome. May God replenish your anointing and anoint you the more. I noticed you are all in white t-shirt and white shirt. And Pastor Daniel also came in white. If I had known, I would have put on my white. But anyhow, we are together. Glory be to Jesus. want to appreciate the guys working behind the scene to make sure that we're able to deliver this message in this manner. May the Lord honor you in Jesus' name. Pastor, thank you again for having us. It's exciting to be here, and I'm really glad to be here. Shall we pray together? Shall we pray together on this night of limitlessness? Lord, we say thank you. None can be compared to you. You are the ever-living God, ever-merciful God, ever-faithful God, ever-glorious and ever-consistent God. Tonight, we bow our hearts, we bow our knees unto you, the Most High, the Monarch of the universe, the one that has answer to every question, solution to every problem. They call you the Waymaker. They call you the Jehovah Jireh. On this mountain, the Lord will provide. They call you the Lord, our banner. Ah, Jehovah Nissi, we praise your name. They call you Jehovah Overdo, the one that does beyond what we are able to ask or think. Tonight, we honor you. Lord, to you shall the gathering of your people be. Tonight, we are excited already at what you are doing and what you are about to do, O God. Give us utterance that will make your word simple in our hearts, that we may say and speak only the things heaven has proposed for tonight. Father, regardless of the notes we have prepared, let only your counsel stand. Let your will be done. Lord, when tonight is over, let somebody's life would have changed forever, O God, even in the name of Jesus. Thank you, precious Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Now, I want to take my teaching tonight. Permit me to teach from 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. I'm talking tonight about limitless living. Youth, living a limitless life. How can I live a limitless life? A life without boundary. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. The Bible says, "But as it is written, I have not seen, nor ear heard, neither have entered into the heart of man the things which God hath prepared for them that love him. But God hath revealed them to us by his Spirit." Why? "For the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of God." Limitless living. Now, when we say limitless, we mean without limit. Without limit, absence of limit. From tonight, I ask and I pray, may your life become limitless. May limits be shattered and broken in the name of Jesus. We mean boundless. In other words, you're free to do as God has proposed and intended for you. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9, the Bible says, "I had not seen." In other words, there is no human being born of a woman who has seen exactly what God wants to do with your life. My God, I'm excited in that. Listen, "Ear had not heard, no ear of any human being has heard the things that God wants to do with you." The Bible says, "Nobody, it hasn't entered the heart of any man, the things God had prepared for certain categories of people." And that's where we're going tonight. These people are going to live a limitless life. My God. These people are going to live a life without boundary. They're going to have limitless vision, limitless desire, limitless ambition, according to the dictionary. In other words, when we say without limits, we mean limitless space. That means they have space to demonstrate, they have space to manifest, they have space to do whatever God has called them to do. So tonight, by the lifting up of my hands on the strength of the prayer prayed tonight, everyone under the sound of my voice will move you to a season of limitless space in Jesus' name. The Bible says, you have caused men to ride over our heads. We went through fire and through water, but you have brought us into a large place. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray for everyone under the sound of my voice. May God move you to a large place, a large place, a place without limit. In the name of Jesus, may your destiny function in a place without limit. May your life function in a place without limit. Somebody shout, no more limit. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, shout limitless. Can I hear you shout limitless? Can I hear you shout limitless? Can I hear you shout limitless? Now, until you understand that God has created you to function without limit, you may not be able to appropriate all that God has created for you. Would you help me again and shout limitless living? Come on, help me shout limitless living. Oh, come on, put your hand on your chest and shout, I am made for limitless living. Come on, talk to me, shout, I am made for limitless living. I'd like you to put your hand on your chest and believe what you're about to say. Say, I am made for limitless living. You know the reason why? What is too big for your mouth to say is too large for your hands to touch. Now, would you put that hand on your chest again and say, I, David Shola Oludoyi, come on. I, David Shola Oludoyi, I am made for limitless living. Glory to God. Limitless living. Limitless living without boundary, without limitation. Glory to God. Now, if we are going to talk about limitless living, then the first thing we want to understand is, what is a limit? I'd like to define first, what is a limit? Limits are several definition, but let me pick several for the sake of tonight. Limit means something that binds. Something that binds. In other words, a bondage. A bondage. In St. Matthew chapter 21, verse 1 and 2, St. Matthew 21, 1 and 2, the Bible says, when they came to a village, Jesus Christ and disciples, they came to a place, he sent 12 disciples to go to a village that was over against them. And they will find a colt and an ass tied between a city and another city. That ass that was tied was limited. Why? It was bound. It was in bondage. It was in bondage. In Acts chapter 16, Paul and Silas were arrested and put in prison. They were bound. They could not move. Therefore, tonight we pray every bondage in your life that has curtailed your life from living a limitless life, let it be broken and shattered in the name of Jesus. Limit means to bind. Limit also means something that restrains. Something that restrains. Something that restrains. In other words, I want to run, but I'm not able to run because something is pulling me back. That is something that restrains. Some of us, habits are restraining us. Some of us, negative words are restraining us. Some of us, life is restraining you. Immigration problems are restraining you. Simply depression is restraining you. Disappointment is restraining you. But tonight, I come in the volume of the book to declare the counsel of the Lord. Let such restraints be shattered, be broken in the name of Jesus. Restrain. To be restrained means you are held back. In Psalms chapter 40, verse 1 to 3, Psalms chapter 40, verse 1 to 3, the Bible says, I cried unto the Lord and he heard me. That's what the Bible says. He heard me, he delivered me, he brought me up out of an horrible pit, a miry clay, and set my feet upon a rock. Now that's the sum total of that scripture. What does that mean? It means that I want to run, I want to be fast, I want to gather speed, but there is something pulling me back. It is called restraint. It is called restraint. Therefore, tonight we declare everything that's restraining your life, lose your hold in Jesus' name. Lose your hold in Jesus' name. What else? Restraint also means or limit means something that confines, something that confines, that says you can go this far, but you cannot go farther. That's something that confines. It keeps you within a particular place. When somebody does not have their papers, for instance, you don't have your immigration card, you can't travel beyond certain places. That is something that confines you. Some people, your education has confined you. Some of us, relationship has confined you. Life has confined you and kept you in a place. But we are in a season of limitless living. Therefore, whatever has confined you tonight, let it be broken. Let it be shattered. Let there be a new beginning. In the name of Jesus Christ, somebody shout, I refuse to be confined. Can you preach with me? Come on now. Let's preach together. Shout, I refuse to be confined. Could you help me? Shout, I refuse to be confined. One more time. Shout, I refuse to be confined. I refuse to be confined. Glory to God. Glory to God. It also means, when we say limit, also means maximum established. In other words, this is the only best you can do, and you can't go further. The devil is a liar. Who is it that said, and it cometh to pass when the Lord has not commanded? God has not put a limit on your life. Therefore, we declare tonight that maximum you will exceed in Jesus' name. Your maximum of today shall be your minimum tomorrow. Can I have a louder amen? Come on. Can I have a better amen? I say your maximum of today shall be your minimum tomorrow. In the name of Jesus, can I prophesy over your life? All of your tithe and offering of this year shall become your normal giving, starting from the month of September, in Jesus' name. God will promote you. God will exceed your limit. You will exceed the best you have today. Your best of today shall be your least tomorrow. In the name of Jesus, expansion is coming your way. Limitlessness is coming your way. Enlargement is coming your way. You are going to fulfill the purpose of God for your life. In the name of Jesus, somebody shout, I receive. Shout, I receive. Shout, I receive. In the name of Jesus. To be limited also means to curtail or reduce. Now, this is important. To curtail or reduce. Now, what do I mean by that? There are people that you share your vision with and they curtail it. They reduce it. They cut it back. You share with them 10 by 10 vision. They tell you, well, nobody has done before. They are there to reduce or to curtail you. That is limiting. In other words, there are people around you that may be limiting you. Tonight, we declare, let there be a new beginning in Jesus' name. To limit also means to demarcate. To demarcate. To put a barrier. To demarcate. Certain parts of town you can't get to, certain kind of career you can't get involved in, certain places you cannot go and preach. Why? Because the enemy has demarcated and said, either though you shall go no further. But the devil is a liar. I have come to speak to you about a God that is not limited, the one that possesses the heaven and earth. Psalm 24 verse 1 says, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. Your God dwells outside of time. He cannot be limited by time, he can't be limited by space, he cannot be limited by matter, and therefore, because he is your God, you too can live a limitless life. Whatever has demarcated you from today before now, whatever has kept you restrained before now, we address it now. Lose your hold in Jesus' name. Let the daughter of Zion go free. Let the man of God go free. Let that young man begin to fulfill his purpose, his destiny, become all that God has created you to be. Somebody shout, amen. Come on, let the church hear the loudest amen. Can you raise the roof in your house and give God a shout of amen? Glory to God. Glory to God. What else do we mean by limit? I like understanding a lot. Limit also means to constrain or to narrow. To constrain or to narrow. A lot of us had big dreams before, but suddenly, reality of life comes to you in certain places, and then you narrow down your dream. That's not the plan of God. God that put the dream in your heart knew what he knew that you could fulfill it. That's why you must refuse to narrow your dream. No, sir, don't narrow that dream for anyone. Glory be to God. We are defining times. Tomorrow I'm coming again. Tomorrow will be different from today. Now, salvation, when you become born again, when you become born again, salvation, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17, Bible says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. In St. John chapter 1, verse 11 and 12, St. John chapter 1, 11 and 12, Bible says, he came unto his own, and his own received him not, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God. So the day you gave your life to Christ, that you became a child of God, several things happened to you. Salvation ushers you into a season and world without limits. I say it again. Salvation ushers you into a season and world without limits. So if you are born again under the sound of my voice, you have been ushered into a world and a season without limits. That's so critical. Number two, for the sake of tonight, salvation ushers you into a season of possibilities. A season of possibilities. In other words, before I became a Christian, impossibilities were normal. But the day I gave my life to Christ, salvation ushers me into a season of possibilities. Who would have believed that ordinary fisherman in Peter, unlearned and ignorant man, will address crowds, thousands of people who give their life to Christ? Who would have believed? As such that in Acts chapter 4, verse 13, Bible says, while they look on them, they took knowledge of them and perceived they were ignorant and unlearned men. So their past was immaterial, but they perceived that they have been with Jesus. My God, salvation changes your status. It changes your world. It changes your possibilities. It changes your potential. It changes your capacity. Salvation makes you a child of God, as such that you can do mighty things for the Almighty God. I'm too glad that you are born again. I'm too glad that you are saved. Glory be to Jesus. Number three, salvation ushers you into a season and world of becoming all you are supposed to be in God. Now, permit me to talk about that for 30 seconds. There is something you are supposed to be in God. In Psalms chapter 40, verse 7, Psalms chapter 40, verse 7, a prophecy about Jesus, Messianic prophecy, says, lo, I come in the volume of the book to do your will, O God, as it is written of me. There are things written about you, young man, young woman, before you are born. In fact, can I preach it tonight, maybe tomorrow? There is a book written about your life in heaven. There is a book about your life in heaven. That book in heaven has got your date of birth on it, D-O-B, and your name at the cover page. And then at the back page, it has got your D-O-D, your date of death. At least there are 7 to 10 chapters in the book. Many people never live through their life. They never pass chapter 1 or chapter 2 of their life. Meanwhile, there is a book about your life. Can you lift your hand to heaven and pray with me and say, Father, everything you have written about me in the volume of the book, I will fulfill it in the name of Jesus. Can I hear you pray? Lift your voice and shout and pray. Lord, all you have written about me in the volume of the book, Father, let me fulfill it. Even by your spirit, let me fulfill it. Let me live out my book. Come on. In the name of Jesus, are you praying at all? Let me live out my book, Jehovah. Makota bera gaduza, zakita katabara gaduse, ekete bregedo soto lo bregadia. Lord, everything you have written about me in the volume of the book, I will live it out. 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 In the name of Jesus, I will live it out, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. You will not be a shadow of yourself. You will not live a less life than you are supposed to live. Listen, the things about you, listen, there is no emergency in heaven. No. God is not trying to prepare what your life will be. Your life was prepared. The book was ready before you showed up on planet Earth. That's why the Bible says, as it is written, I have not seen, hear hath not heard, it has not entered the heart of man. What God had prepared, past tense, past participle, not God may prepare, two different things. He had prepared them. So I want to usher you, young man, young woman, into a season of entering the prepared place. Not the next level anymore. We are coming to the prepared level. I changed my prayer years ago from, Lord, take me to the next level. No, I don't want next level. Take me to the prepared level. There is a prepared place for you in destiny, sir. Heaven fashioned it before you were born. Tonight, I prophesy over you by the lifting of my hands. Each of us, we come into the prepared place in Jesus' name. Jonah would have been a colossal failure of a prophet, because the prepared place of fulfillment was in Nineveh. But life would not allow him to go there. He decided to run to Tarshish. Thank God for the whale that swallowed him and gave him a submarine ride onto Nineveh so that he could fulfill destiny. Prepared place where he was going to get 100% conversion rate. Can you imagine? Meanwhile, he wanted to go and preach elsewhere. Can I pray for you? You will no longer labor in vain in Jesus' name. You will no longer fish in shallow waters in the name of Jesus. You will no longer labor where God has not sent you in the name of Jesus Christ. Someone lift your voice and say, oh Lord, take me to the prepared place in the name of Jesus. Can I hear you pray like you mean it? Say, Lord, take me to the prepared place. Come on now. Say, Lord, take me to the prepared place in the name of Jesus. Take me to the prepared place in the name of Jesus. Take me to the prepared place in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are prayed. Glory to God. The next thought I want to bring to you quickly, and I won't preach on this because I had the presentation to be shown to you, but I think there are one or two technical issues, is that there is a fundamental difference between God and man. Fundamental difference between God and man. All right? God is self-existent. What is? Man cannot exist alone. God is the beginning. Man showed up later. God has no need. Man has many needs. God is omnipotent. Man is not almighty. God is all present. Man is limited by space and time. This is important. God is omniscient. Man is limited in knowledge. Why God speaks from eternity? Because of his perfect knowledge. Man many a times only speaks based on his five senses, on what he can see. God's wisdom is unsearchable, unfathomable, yet man is subject to all kinds of things and pressure in life. Now, why have I said this to you? Is that God is the original limitless being. God is unlimited, is limitless. And as a child of God, your love can be limitless. Your faith can be limitless. Glory to God. Your prayers can be limitless. Your praises can be limitless. When it's time to praise God tonight, I hope you are going to praise God. Your worship can be limitless. Your giving can be limitless. Ladies and gentlemen, these are dimensions of non-limitation in God. Why? The best of men in their best are ordinary men. Men are always going to be limited. Only God is limitless. As a young man, as a young woman, I want to submit to you tonight, you can live a limitless life if only you connect yourself with God that is limitless. Glory to Jesus. God cannot be held bound. He cannot be held back. And that's why if you are properly connected to him, you can begin to live a limitless life. A limitless life is a fruitful life. A limitless life is an enviable life. A limitless life is a life with proof, with evidence. My God, a limitless life is a life that men would like to be like. A limitless life is a life of impact and input. A limitless life is a life of influence. A limitless life is a life that others want to be like. A limitless life is a life that is attractive. My God, from tonight we prophesy over you and declare your life shall be limitless in Jesus' name. I say you shall live a limitless life, a life that will honor God, a life that will bring many to Christ, a life that will cause others to want to know your God in the name of Jesus Christ, a life like the life of Daniel, like the life of Joseph, a limitless life in the name of Jesus, a life that will change destinies. My God, that shall be your portion from tonight in the name of Jesus. For the Bible says in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. A limitless life. Glory to God. A limitless life. If you, Genesis chapter 5, verse 24. Genesis 5, 24. And Enoch walked with God, and he was not, for God took him. Enoch lived a limitless life, and God took him to be with him. From tonight, I declare over you, daughter of Zion, man of God, if your amen can be loud, you can receive this blessing. From today, we confer on you. We give you an ordination of limitlessness in Jesus' name. In Acts chapter 1, verse 8, Acts 1:8, the Bible says, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and uttermost parts of the earth. In other words, by the coming of the Holy Ghost upon you, you begin to live a limitless life. Ladies and gentlemen, because I'm talking in this kind of forum tonight, let me now share with you seven factors out of several we can share. Seven factors that will ensure that you live a limitless life. Seven factors that will remove limits from your life. Seven factors that will ensure, as a young man, you live a limitless life. Glory to God. Remember Psalm 60, verse 11. Psalm 60, verse 11 says, give us help from trouble, for vain is the help of man. So we want to look at that scripture and find out what are the things I need to live a limitless life. Seven factors very quickly. Number one, you need God. G-O-D. You need God. The truth of the matter is that life will attempt to put limit on you. And you must understand, even though you are a free human being, you are not an independent human being. You are not independent. You need help. God has always walked through people. At Calvary, he came personally to rescue you and I from sin. But from then, he began to walk through people. That's why tonight I'm going to talk about seven important things that will remove limits, that will usher you to limitless living in the name of Jesus Christ. No matter who you are, you will need people to do well in life. You will need people to succeed in life. Please hear me. You need people in your life. And the first factor that will ensure you live a limitless life is what I call the G factor or God factor. You must be born again. If you are not born again, you are not safe. In John chapter 15, verse 5, John 15, verse 5 says, I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, You can do nothing. I like you to remember that. Without God, you and I can do nothing. Nothing, 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 absolutely. So shout, I need God. Come on, I say shout, I need God. You need God. In Psalm 127 verse 1, Psalm 127 verse 1, the Bible says, except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. In other words, the God factor is what brings success. Somebody shout, Lord, I need you. Listen to me. God is the greatest limit remover in your life and my life. Psalm 84, verse 11. Psalm 84, verse 11. The Bible says, each of them appeareth in Zion. They go from strength unto strength. Every time you appear in Zion, you go to a new level of strength. Psalm 84, verse 11. In 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 6, 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6, Bible says, I, Paul, have planted. What did it say? Apollos watered. But look at, but God gave the increase. It is the God factor that makes a difference in your life. I pray for you in the name of Jesus. You will never fight God. You will never walk against God. May God be on your side in the name of Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible said, if God be for us, who can be against us? The God factor. In Micah chapter 2, verse 13. Micah chapter 2, verse 13. It says, the breaker is come up before them. They have broken up. They have passed through the gate and are gone out by it, and their king shall pass before them, and the Lord on the head of them. From tonight, I pray for you as a child of God, a daughter of Zion, the breaker will go before you. It will break every limit in the name of Jesus. Somebody shall, Lord, go ahead of me. So important. Number two, you need the Holy Spirit. God the Father, because you are born again through Jesus, you need the Holy Spirit. Why is that important? Because he's the chief executive of the Father on earth. Nothing can happen on earth today without the Holy Ghost. That's why the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, 9 and 10, in verse 10, it says, but he has revealed them to us by his Spirit. There are things the Holy Spirit must reveal to you. For he that searcheth the mind of the Father knoweth what's the mind of the Father. He that searcheth the mind of the Spirit, rather, knows what's in the mind of the Father. The Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit. Mary, how will you become significant? How will you live a limitless life? They say the power of the Highest shall overshadow you, and the Holy Ghost shall come upon you. Somebody shout, Holy Spirit, I need you. I'm talking to young people tonight. These are serious habits you must cultivate to relate with the Holy Spirit. It's so important. Romans chapter 8, verse 26. We do not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself will make intercessions for us with groanings that cannot be uttered or explained. The Holy Ghost is the chief executive of the Father on planet Earth. You need him so desperately to lead a limitless life. Number three, to lead a limitless life, you need your prophet. Somebody shout, I need my prophet. Now, please don't miss this point. Many people think in life, I can do what I want to do. I'm okay. I don't need anybody. No, it's a joke. You need your prophet. In Habakkuk, in Hosea, chapter 12, verse 13, I'm going to have to rush through this because of time. Hosea chapter 12 and verse 13. The Bible says, and by a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet was he preserved. Are you getting that? God used a prophet to bring Israel out of Egypt. Listen to me. You need your prophet. Your prophet is your pathfinder, is your dream interpreter, is your backup. You need your prophet. A rolling stone gathers no dust. You need your prophet. Your prophet is your pastor. Well, I know what I'm doing. No, you need your man of God. Please don't miss this point. You need your man of God. He's not perfect, but he's your prophet. Glory to God. Ah, there could be no King Saul without Samuel. There'll be no David without Samuel. You need your prophet. There would have been no Samuel without Eli. You need your prophet. Glory to God. Stop running a bastard spirit. You don't need that. You need your pastor who can prophesy on you, who can pray for you. PDSO, what do you mean? Second Chronicles chapter 20 and verse 20. Second Chronicles 20, Bible says, and they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, now hear this, hear me, O Resurrection House. Hear me, O Resurrection Chapel. Hear me, O young people. Hear me, O Limitless 2020. And ye inhabitants of USA, New Jersey, New York, hear this, Bronx. Believe in the Lord your God. You shall be established. Establish me, you stand. Your feet are on the ground where you believe God. But he said, believe his prophet, his man of God, and you shall prosper. To prosper means you will make progress. Many people have not been making progress because they have despised their pastor. They have despised their man of God. They have treated him as if he's their buddy or he's their friend. Beloved, you better repent tonight. Young man, in this age, we are running a bastardized spirit, thinking we don't need anybody. No, you need your pastor. He's your pathfinder. Listen, when he says go, you go. You will succeed in what he's telling you. Tonight, I pray for you. May you enjoy one more time the ministry of your pastor in Jesus' name. Number four, you need what I call way pavers. People that will pave way for you. I call them way pavers. They will pave way for you. Listen, these are humans, human beings who have gone ahead of you, that you need to climb on their shoulder to get to where you are going. Zacchaeus wanted to see Jesus. Luke chapter 19. Bible said he climbed a sycamore tree so that he could have a vantage position. Listen to me. You need human beings. We call them way pavers, who can introduce you to their generation, who can give you the next information you need, who can introduce you to their connection, who can take you to certain places in life. You need those people. Do you know that even Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who was anointed from heaven, he needed people like this? You don't believe me? Let's read together. John chapter 1, verse 29 and 30. John chapter 1, verse 29 and 30. John chapter 1, 29 and 30. The Bible says, the next day, John sees Jesus coming to him and said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. John the Baptist introduced Jesus. If he never introduced Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, nobody would have listened to Jesus, even though he was the Son of God. Even though he was the anointed one and his anointed, but he needed a platform to introduce him. Today, I pray for you. God will give you a secure platform that will introduce you to your world, a way paver that will show you the way in the name of Jesus. Jesus needed John the Baptist to point him out. Can I ask you a question tonight? Which finger is pointing you out and which finger is pointing at you? That's why tonight, whoever you are, if God has blessed you, share your grace with others. It's going to be a blessing. Isaac Newton said, the scientist, he said, I have seen further because I have ridden on the shoulders of those who have gone ahead of me. That's why I want to ask you tonight, be careful how you treat people. You never know who has information for your limitless living. Be careful how you handle people. Without David, without Jonathan, David would never have had access to certain places. You need people. Andrew found Jesus and he brought his brother to Jesus. Even though the brother later became the head of the church, but it was Andrew that went to bring his brother. Listen to me, you need way pavers in life, human beings that will point you out. Today I pray every accusation finger pointing at you, let them wither in Jesus' name. But Lord, let some fingers of honor, fingers of grace, fingers of mercy point you out to their generation in the name of Jesus. In Acts chapter 9, you can read it later, verse 26 and 27. When Saul was come to Jerusalem, he essayed to join himself to disciples, but they were afraid of him and believed not that he was a disciple. Apostle Paul, who saw Jesus, who had the encounter in chapter 9, the Bible says, they said, we don't believe this guy. We don't trust him. But Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles and declared to them how he has seen the Lord, that he has spoken to him, how he appeared boldly at Damascus in the name of Jesus. Lift your hand to heaven and say, oh Lord, let my Barnabas locate me and introduce me to their world. In the name of Jesus, man of God, can you pray, Lord, let Barnabas hold my hand and introduce me to their world. In the name of Jesus, Father, let my Barnabas locate me. Makata labro sopa lebra gadaya. Ekale kateba katuza gadabayando. Let Barnabas locate me in the name of Jesus. Father, release Barnabas into my life. Oh God, let Barnabas locate me tonight. Let Barnabas locate me tonight in the name of Jesus. Lord, let Barnabas locate me tonight. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. May Barnabas locate you in the name of Jesus. Number five, you need what I call recommenders. Recommenders. These are not fingers that point you out. These are recommenders. Listen to this story. Don't forget it. We don't have a lot of time. The Bible says in Esther chapter 1, when you read home, read it from verse 14 to 21. Esther chapter 1, 14 to 21. I will tell you this story. The Bible says to us that the king had wanted his wife, Vashti, to come and entertain his guests. And Vashti felt, no, I wouldn't come out. Cut a long story short, she refused to come out. And then the Bible says, people were not happy. Several princes who sat with the king were not happy. And then the king said, what shall be done unto Queen Vashti according to law? Because she didn't perform the commandment of King Ahasuerus. In verse 16, don't miss this point. Verse 16, and Memucan answered before the king and the princes and began to speak and said, this and this and this has this woman done. In verse 21, the Bible says, and the same pleased the king and the princes. Nobody gets far in life without a recommender. There is a Memucan that must recommend you. Even if I stop now, it's okay. You will pray tonight, Lord, let Memucan speak good of me before the king. There are people that have the king's ear. They must speak good about you. I call them recommenders to live a limitless life. You need recommenders. I've seen anointed people who are annoyed. Listen to me, vision without provision is television. We are going to pray tonight, Lord, release Memucans into my life. Those who have the king's ears, who will speak for me, who will speak goodwill, who will speak good for me, who have the goodwill of the king. They are the ones that will speak into your life. Oh, Lord, I pray, let Memucans speak for me. In the name of Jesus, let Memucans speak for me. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Listen to me. Do you know that if Memucan had not spoken to the king's ear, there would have never been Queen Esther? Memucas must be released on our behalf, every young man, to go and speak on your behalf in Jesus' name. I want to close because of time now. I will not be able to go through the rest of them. In other words, be careful how you treat your spiritual parents, your natural parents. Show them love. Number six, you need people are called runners of your vision. I won't preach on it. God will just help you to understand it. Runners of your vision. People who are committed to you, who have committed their life to you, who are saying, this is the man. Anything you do, I will do with you. Without them, you can't live a limitless life. I call them runners of your vision. They are image makers. They are helpers of your life. They are your light bearers. They are the ones that will fight for you when you can't fight. They are the ones that will stand for you when you can't stand. They are the ones that will protect you when others desert you. I call them runners of your vision. May God send you runners of your vision in the name of Jesus. Do you know who these people are? You become their ministry and their vision. You become their number one reason why they are alive. Runners of your vision. Glory to God. Number seven, you need mentors. Mentors. These are people who have done what you are trying to do before now, who can mentor you. They've gone ahead. They've gone through the pain. They can prevent you from going through the pain. They inspire you. They direct you. They comfort you. Your mentors are not your friends. Their assignment is to make sure you get there. Mentors don't look for mentees. Mentees look for mentors. You have Paul and Timothy. These are mentors. You have Naomi and Ruth. You have Mordecai and Esther. Mentors in life. Glory to God. Listen to me. Mentors are so important. These are people that will tell you the truth because they don't fear you, but they love you enough not to allow you to die in your pain. So honor your mentors. Sow to their lives. Call them, let them pray for you. Your mentors. And then number eight, and I'll stop tonight. You need enemies in life. Enemies. I know somebody is saying, Pastor, how can you say I need enemies? Yes, you need enemies. You know why? Enemies will keep you on your toes. Enemies will keep you praying. Enemies will keep you trusting God. Enemies will keep you honoring God. Enemies will keep driving you to the house of God. You need some enemies in your life. Enemies are not necessarily bad people. No, they just make sure that you're on your toes. Pastor, what do you mean? Psalm 23 verse 5, he prepares a table where before me in the presence of my enemies. Why didn't he kill all of them? No. He had to make sure they are there to paralyze them to see you succeed. You need enemies. You need some Peninnas in your life. Peninna, in 1 Samuel chapter 1, verse 2 and 4, Bible says a man had two wives. Name of one was Anna. The other one was Peninna. Peninna had children. Anna had no children. And Peninnah was always tormenting Anna. That's why Anna went to pray. If Peninnah was not tormenting Anna, Anna would never pray. Ladies and gentlemen, these are few factors that will enable you to live a limitless life. But I want you to pray. Pastor, I'm going to take another 5 minutes before I end this. I want us to pray. But before I pray, you see, your success is very sweet when there are enemies that are watching you succeed. Peninnah became a provoker of destiny for Anna. Hebrews chapter 9, verse 27 says, "As it is appointed to men to die only once, after this, the judgment." Remember, I told you the most important factor is God. If you are here tonight, wherever you're watching us from, and you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I beg of you, tonight is your night. You want to make sure you settle your account tonight. Or perhaps your relationship with Jesus Christ is not at the level it can be. You want to settle your account tonight also. So I'd like you to please, wherever you are, bow your head. Signal, actually if you are watching online, signal by raising your hand, bow your heart and bow your head and say after me. It's a relationship. If you are also backsliding, can I ask you an honest question before you pray? If Jesus were to come tonight If you are not sure you are going to go with him to heaven, bow your head and pray with me. If Jesus were to come right now, you are not sure you are going to make heaven. Listen, it's not about title. It's not about how long you have been in church. The reason why you are struggling with some things is because you are not connected properly. Bow your head now and let us pray. Say after me, dear Lord Jesus, tonight I come to you as a sinner who needs a savior. Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. Forgive me my sins. Write my name in the book of life. Wash me in your blood. From today, I accept you as my Lord and Savior. And I say bye-bye to Satan. I now declare I am a child of God. Thank you, O Lord. In Jesus' name. If you pray that prayer and you mean it, communicate with the church. Email is there. Number is there. And let them know you have prayed this prayer. Now, if you are backsliding before, or your relationship with Jesus Christ is not at the level it should be, beloved, I have spoken to you tonight. God has spoken to you because we are going to pray 5 quick prayers. And for you to get the best out of the prayer, your relationship with Jesus Christ must be right. If it comes today, I hope you will make heaven and mend your ways. Are you ready to pray? Now lift your voice. Say, Father, come on. I can say, oh Lord, every barrier around me holding me back from living a limitless life, let the barriers be broken tonight in the name of Jesus. Can you rise on your feet and pray and say, oh Lord, come on, rise on your feet. Say, oh Lord, every barrier that has been put around my life that's had held me back from living a limitless life, let the barrier be broken. As a young man, as a young woman, Lord, let the barrier be broken tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, let the barrier be broken tonight. Let the barrier be broken tonight. In the name of Jesus, somebody pray. Let the barrier be broken. Let the barrier be broken. Let the barrier be broken. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Number 2, you will pray and say, Lord, from tonight, say, Lord, from tonight, release into my life, oh God, every way paver, every recommender I need. Father, release them to my life in the name of Jesus. Help me to treat them right. Lord, from tonight, release way pavers into my life. Release recommenders into my life in the name of Jesus. Father, release recommenders into my life in the name of Jesus. Jehovah, release them. Jehovah, release them. Jehovah, release them. Release recommenders into my life in the name of Jesus. Oh, my Father, release recommenders right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Number 3, you will pray. Say, Father, say, oh Lord, release my Barzillai the Gileadite. Barzillai the Gileadite, release him into my life tonight. My collaborators of life. Somebody go ahead and pray. Say, Lord, release my collaborators of life into me in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, release my collaborators of life. Father, release them. Father, release them. In the name of Jesus, Lord, release my collaborators. Release my collaborators. Release my collaborators. In the name of Jesus, men and women that will collaborate with me. In the name of the Lord, release my Barzillai the Gileadite. In the name of Jesus, come on. Lord, release them to me. Release them to me. Release Barzillai the Gileadite. In the name of Jesus, Father, release such people to my life tonight. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Abba Father. Glory to your name, oh God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And finally, say, Lord, help me never to mess around with my pastor. Can you go ahead and pray? Lord, help me recognize and appreciate the ministry of my pastor in my life. Come on, go ahead and begin to pray. Help me appreciate, help me appreciate, help me appreciate the ministry of my pastors in my life. In the name of Jesus, come on now. Help me appreciate the ministry of the man of God in my life, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Now you are going to do something for me for 2 minutes. Rise on your feet, wherever you are. Rise on your feet. Now begin to pace up and down. And begin to declare, I, David Shola Ludoyi, I step into a season of limitless living. Where my life will fall to me in pleasant places. I will marry on time. I will build house on time. I will save souls on time. I will preach on time. I will love the Lord well. Come on, begin to pray. Heaven shall be pleased with me. Begin to declare, this nation will serve me. This nation will cooperate with me. In the name of Jesus, no more barrier. No more confinement. In the name of Jesus, I come out of the prison yard of life. I become all I'm supposed to be in God. Go ahead and begin to pray. Yes, 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 yes. Chapel of Restoration, lift a voice and pray. As you mark, watch up and down in this house of restoration, in this chapel of restoration, lift a voice and pray. Say, Lord, I will not be limited. I will not be held back. I will not be held bound. I possess my possession. I become all I shall be in God. Everything God has prepared for me, I shall become it. I shall behave it. I shall become it. I shall live it out. In the name of Jesus, say, Lord, let my visioner look for me. Let them come looking for me. All the helpers of destiny that will help me. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to pray. Let there be a cutting away, a cutting back of everyone that do not belong in my tomorrow. Father, cut them off tonight. Cut them off tonight. Cut them off tonight. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Can I hear your loudest amen, church? Wherever you are watching us from, if you are on YouTube, could you type amen? Let's know that you are alive. Shout the loudest amen by typing it right now in the name of Jesus. Now let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we say thank you. Thank you for your word has come tonight. Thank you for how you started with us. Limitless Living Part 1. Lord, we have laid foundation tonight that you are the greatest factor for limitless living. Therefore, I pray, whatever area of our life is displeasing to you, let there be a turnaround tonight in Jesus' name. Lord, we break the yoke of stagnation. Relationship that is not pleasing in your life to us, Father, we destroy in the name of Jesus. Lord, we destroy in the name of Jesus. We declare a new season has dawned upon us. And now, usher you, man of God, daughter of Zion, with your hand lifted to heaven, I usher you now to limitless living in the name of Jesus. Your lives will fall to you in pleasant places from the north, the east, the west, and the south. Your help will come. Fingers shall begin to point you out. Recommenders will find you. Runners of your vision will find you in the name of Jesus. I soak you in the blood of Jesus. I saturate you in the blood of Jesus. Your way shall be straight before you. The enemy will not hold you back. No, sir. They will not limit you. The grace of God shall be sufficient for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Abba Father. Your eyes of understanding shall be enlightened. You will see what God has laid before you so that you can step into them, so that you can appropriate them. In the name of Jesus Christ, let it be so. Thank you, precious Redeemer. We give you the glory and the praise, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we are prayed. Amen. Somebody shout amen. Come on. Shout amen. Come on, one more time. Shout amen. And now declare, I am made for limitless living. Come on. God bless you. I'll see you tomorrow. Let me welcome
Let's pray for increased grace, that the Lord will increase him on every side. God has used him powerfully to bless us today. Let's pray for refilling. Let's pray for re-energizing. Let's pray for refiring. That as he returns back tomorrow, it will be with greater grace. In the name of Jesus, let's bless the name of the Lord for his family, that God will continue to prosper his work in his hands from glory to greater glory. In the name of Jesus Christ. One thing I didn't mention regarding when I introduced Pastor Sola is by the special grace of God, is also the prayer warrior coordinator for RCCG in UK. You can imagine what is going to happen tomorrow. Tomorrow is the deliverance night and limitless live part 2. So I want you to go and break the news of what has happened here tonight. Go and tell people that God is working wonders in restoration, Chapel of Restoration. So tomorrow, come with your friends, come with your loved ones, come with your family members, and everyone that you want to be blessed. Come with them, and I believe God of heaven, we are going to be blessed. Wow, 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 tomorrow. We want to celebrate all our viewers across the globe. Thank you for signing in. Thank you for sharing, you know, this meeting with your friends, your contact. We pray that even as we gather together again tomorrow, is going to be greater than tonight. How many of us have really been blessed tonight? Shout a loud hallelujah one more time. As we bring tonight's meeting to a close, let's share the grace together in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. I want to encourage you also to share your praise report on our website, and also if you have any prayer request, you can post it there. Then we take it off from there. God bless you. Have a great night. Bye.
This is the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Chapel of Restoration, located at 1001-1005 Morris Avenue, Bronx, New York, where we prepare a whole people in an unholy world. Welcome back to church. We have measures in place in line with the CDC guidelines for your safety. The sanctuary has been thoroughly sanitized and disinfected, so be rest assured that you will be worshiping the Lord in a clean and healthy environment. Carefully listen to the following information for your safety and the safety of others, and please comply with them. If you drive, complimentary parking is available at 283rd East 164th Street between College and Morris Avenues. When you come into the church, remember to stay 6 feet apart from others at all times. Face masks are required before entering the church. If you do not have one, it will be provided to you free of charge at the door. Please put it on immediately. New York State requires you to wear a face mask, so do we. Your temperature will be checked before given the all clear signal to enter the sanctuary. Hand sanitizers are also available at the door. Use it before entering the church. Our ushers will then direct you to your designated seats based on your family size. Please obey all instructions. The seats have been arranged so that members of the same family can sit together but are 6 feet apart from others. Additional safety instructions will be given to you once you are seated. There will be no children's church. Parents will sit together with their children, and we ask parents to take care of their children. Please do not allow your child to run or walk around the church. Children over 2 years of age are expected to wear a mask. If you need to use the restroom, hand washing soap and sanitizers have been provided for your convenience. When the service is over, we ask that you follow the directions of the ushers as you leave. Remember to keep your mask on and stay 6 feet apart at all times. Your health and safety are important to us, so we ask that you adhere to all instructions.
Please register to attend this Sunday service on www.rocgchapelofrestoration.org. Only 100 seats are available.
We've missed you and can't wait to see you back as we worship the Lord together.
CDC is trying. Nobody really knows what is going on except God. And Nobody really had the answer except God. Thank God for the doctors. Medical personnel, they are running away from work because they are overwhelmed. They are overloaded. Many of them have lost their life in the course of saving the life of those who are affected. Right here in our very eyes, we see Bible coming to pass, the word of God. In a time like this, what is the answer? The answer is what the three young Hebrew men said. Their confession as the answer said, our God that we serve will deliver us.